This is the process shot. I'm Michael. I'm stuck in a haunted movie theater, and I've seen The Atomic Submarine, a science fiction B-movie kind of deal from 1959, directed by Spencer Gordon Bennett. It follows the crew of the USS Tiger Shark, a nuclear-powered submarine, in its journey to the Arctic Circle, in an attempt to unearth the cause of a number of unusual events that have all resulted in the loss of ships. Despite some animosity, specifically an officer's dislike for the pacifistic son of a personal friend, the Tiger Shark crew reach the Arctic Circle and find their target, though they are shocked to learn that what they've been after all this time isn't some rogue country or even a giant animal, but an alien spacecraft capable of underwater travel. The concept alone opens things up for some fun ideas to be had, whether it involves whatever lurks beneath the waters or what the submarine itself is capable of accomplishing. Unfortunately, the movie doesn't really do much to spread its wings, keeping its story rather streamlined rather than exploring the possibilities or impossibilities that an atomic submarine could accomplish. It also doesn't do too much with the sub-conflict set up by the commanding officer and the pacifist doctor, giving it some attention and using it to build up a relatively small amount of character between the two, but otherwise letting it go by the wayside. The end result is a bit of a slog, not so much in that the movie is slow and drags itself out, but rather that little of interest happens all that much. There's a lull in action, then a burst of story, and then back to a crawl. Even when the alien spacecraft is reached, and you think that things will pick up, the pattern continues. That all said, the atomic submarine is pretty clearly made more as a vehicle for the special effects work, which isn't particularly realistic, but still shows a great amount of effort in making things look as exciting as possible. Granted, the actual mechanics of the effects aren't all that impressive either, but it still blends together well with the actual actors and set pieces in the final edit, as well as present a living sort of imagination to the more paranormal elements of the story, making for a good contrast to the rest of the film and its less than exciting play-by-play of military action. It also allows for a bit of variety, especially when it comes to the alien ship and its own immediate contrast to the human environments and structure. Speaking of which, the set pieces are designed pretty well, maybe not so much as parts of a submarine as a whole, but at least as environments that aren't limited to the bare minimum for a scene. Overall, though, the movie doesn't offer much strength outside of its effects. The story and characters are a bit weak, and its other elements are on par with any other B-movie. But I think that because of this, it doesn't concern itself too much with being a deeper look at nuclear power or anti-war sentiments. It's just a pretty fun science fiction movie about a submarine and an alien. Not much else to it. The Atomic Submarine, Spencer Gordon Bennett, 1959. 2.5 stars. I'd say it's worth a watch. That's it for me. If you liked this review, leave it a like. If you didn't, leave a comment. As always, subscribe to the channel for more reviews. It's actually kind of weird that they didn't try to shoehorn in some greater conflict between war and peace and all that jazz. Maybe they just needed to keep the movie under 90 minutes.